Hello, Agate. Today is Monday, April 15th. I'm Sean.
And I'm Connor.
Please stand for the pledges.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. Honor the Texas flag. I pledge allegiance to thee, Texas, one state under God, one and indivisible.
Remember, today, sixth graders will hear an AVID presentation in the cafeteria at 2:30.
Today, April 15th, is tax day. But why do we pay taxes anyway?
While we invest part of our savings to help finance the world's most efficient business system, at the same time we pay taxes to government to finance many kinds of services which also contribute to our way of life. For example, our taxes must provide the necessary funds to improve and expand our school system. Our taxes must be sufficient to pay for city streets, health, fire, and police protection, and of course, aid to the needy. Our state taxes help pay for highways, educational institutions, and among other things, help to finance important experiments to increase the productivity of our farms. Our federal taxes pay for irrigation and reclamation projects, for national parks, postal services, the Weather Bureau, and many other services. Our taxes have to pay for the enormous cost of past wars and provide the funds for a defense program which will ensure the safety of our country. In addition, all of us should be willing to pay whatever taxes are necessary to enable efficient government to improve or expand any essential service. But with our present tax load, we should avoid pressuring government for any new services that aren't absolutely necessary. Because we all know the more our government provides, the more taxes it's forced to collect. None of us can escape. Big business. Small business. Farmers. Workers. Housewives and all of us have to pay our share. Demanding more and more from government could create a tax burden heavy enough to crack essential blocks in the foundation of our business system.
Hi, I'm Taylor.
And I'm Rachel.
Don't forget, if you want to do middle school athletics next year, you must have a physical.
Physicals will be done on April 30th at the high school arena. Now for our Safety Monday.
It's important to know what steps to take when we have a bad weather day at school.
Shelter. Whenever there's a forecast for severe weather like a tornado, you may have to take shelter in your classroom. So what do we do when we hear the siren or announcement? One. An announcement will be made to go into shelter locations. Two, students will listen for their teacher to direct them to their designated location labeled on their room evacuation map. This area will be away from windows and close to an interior wall. If you are outside or in the portable, go inside immediately.
3. Students should be silent while moving to their shelter location. 4. The teacher will show students where in the room to get into the duck and cover position.
5. Another announcement will be made if and when a student needs to duck and cover. 6. Everyone will continue to duck and cover until an announcement is made that the drill or severe weather threat has lifted.
Remember, shelter and duck and cover keeps us safe from severe weather.
Have a miracle Monday, Woodgate!